Awesome. Thanks so much, Phil. Hi, everyone. I'm Colin, co-founder at Clerk. And today I'm going to show you how to build a B2B SaaS app in 10 minutes. So that's going to be everything from the sign-up flow to the sign-in flow to the user profile screen to the create organization flow, invite members to that organization flow, and then the organization profile screen. Before I do that, I actually want to spend a minute talking a little about our philosophy on DevTools at Clerk. Ultimately, I think that's why we're here at Jamstack Conf instead of like an identity conference. At Clerk, we believe the component is the new REST API. And I guess what I mean by that is for the last generation, DevTools have really been structured so that you need to have a backend developer implement some REST SDK, copy some data into their database, then plumb that data down to their front end for a front end developer to kind of munge that data into ultimately an end user feature, which is what we want. And what's great about the Jamstack is there's a higher level of abstraction now called the component, and we could actually tidally wrap all of that functionality just into a component and drop it right in the web page. And so that's how we think about things at Clerk, and that's what you're going to see today. All right, so build a B2B SaaS app in 10 minutes. Slide guy, my timer's wrong. Heads up. Everything here is available today. So if you've known Clerk before, we've always been a user management company. Starting today, we are a customer management company, so we're doing both user management and organization management. If you already have us in NPM, you're going to have to reinstall to get these new features. And there's 7 steps to get started. So first things first, you need to set your environment variables. I like to start here just for completeness, but you have to go to the dashboard, copy some environment variables, put them into your .env file. Next is pretty standard boilerplate as well. You go into the Clerk provider, into your React app's entry point, wrap it in a Clerk provider. And what that does is it provides the auth state, the user state, to the rest of the application. And then from here, we get a little more domain specific. So we have these signed in and signed out components. And what I'm doing in the code sample here, this is how most B2B SaaS apps work. When you're signed in, you want to show children. And that's kind of the whole React application. When you're signed out, you want to redirect to sign in. And that sign-in page is the next step here. This is how you mount a sign-up and a sign-in page in Clerk. You just import these components, drop them on the page, and this is what they render. So ultimately, these are just ridiculously customizable sign-up components, and that's customizable in 2 dimensions. First here is just the capabilities of the sign-in itself. So on the left, I've got Google or email. In the middle, I put on some more OAuth factors. On the right, it's just phone number based. There's thousands of permutations. You just select them in the dashboard, and we'll get it going. The next dimension is actually like the UI customization. And I think we're at Clerk held to a higher standard here than most other embeddables. And that's just because sign up and sign in is very much the gateway, the entry point to your app. And so the branding really needs to be perfect. So, you know, we have the standard thing of like pass as your primary color and we'll make all the components kind of match. But then we actually document every single HTML element that we put on the page. And we let you pass us a style dictionary or CSS class names to append to that element. And so you can pass us Tailwind class names, you could use CSS modules, you could use global CSS, whatever you want to do, you can do incredibly granular customization of these components. So that was sign up and sign in. Next step is the user button. And so user button probably doesn't mean anything to you, but you've almost certainly seen them before. It's that thing that goes in like the top right of a million different websites. And I took like Stripe, Twitter, Google, Netlify. You click it, it's like the waypoint to signing out, to managing the profile. And that's the same thing for us. So we have this component. We actually built in the Google functionality of like being able to sign in to multiple accounts at once. You just drop that user button in your header, and you get everything you need. When you click Manage Account, that pops open a user profile modal by default. You can mount it so it opens up a page instead. And the profile is fully featured, all just out of the box. So profile image uploads, I'm sure everyone loves building that. It just comes with it. MFA, it all works collaboratively with the sign-in component, so you don't have to do any extra work. Your user can just go set up MFA, and sign in will work. And then even active device management. So that's a security feature. Comes out of the box. People can see which devices they're signed in on and remotely sign out. That was user button. And then today, these are our new features. So we've got our organization switcher starting today. It's the same thing kind of for B2B SaaS. So again, you've probably seen an element like this before. You want your users to be able to enroll in multiple organizations in your SaaS. A lot of you also want your user to have like a personal organization. You see that on like a Netlify and a GitHub. And so we support that out of the box. And this organization switcher, much like the user button, is the waypoint for creating organizations as well as managing an organization. So I'll show the create organization flow first. This includes hopefully exactly what you expect, kind of upload a logo if you want, set an organization name, and then invite members. We handle all of the complexity of inviting members. And so sometimes when you're handling an invitation, the user already exists, and so you're just enrolling them into the org. Sometimes you actually have to get them into the application and then into the org. And so we handle all of that complexity all just behind create organization, which is ultimately behind the org switcher. And then the last thing here is the org profile. So if you click that manage profile button from the org switcher, this comes up. Again, it's like UIs you've seen before. You guys shouldn't be rebuilding these things. Just use Clerk. Set people's roles, invite members, remove members, whatever you need to do. Last thing here is the back end, right? So everything we've done so far has been on the front end. We haven't touched the back end yet. It's actually really cool that we can get all of that functionality working without touching back end at all. Clerk is powering APIs that directly face your front end, so you don't need to touch it. But when it does come time for you to actually build your app, you need to get that data in your back end. And so this is an example of what the SDK looks like in Next.js. But we have similar for Express, Rails, Go, whatever you need, really. Behind the scenes, this is a JWT set in a cookie. It's pulling and refreshing automatically for XSS stuff. And out of it, you can get the user ID, the active org ID, and then the role of the active member in that org. And that's normally all you need to perform some kind of authorization. If you're, you know, one of the people that uses, I call them alternative backends in this slide. It's not a great phrase because it's actually 26% of our customers are using one of these. And a lot of our peers, I think, are actually here today. But we'll actually generate JWTs so that you can authorize users into these systems as well. So we'll generate a JWT that's like the right shape for Supabase or Convex or GraphBase or whatever. And so you can query these tools directly from the front end. That's it. That's the seven steps to building a B2B SaaS app with Clerk. If you want to speed run this, you could probably pull it off in like 5 minutes. It really is a lot of fun to play with. Give it a try. I'm Colin. I'm Tweets by Colin on Twitter. We're Clerk Dev on Twitter. Find me after the conference. Love to chat. Thanks.